Good afternoon, I'm Patrick Serrano, and this is the KQBH News Update. A half-naked man was taken into custody in Boyle Heights last night after he climbed to the roof of St. Mary's Catholic Church and lit a cross on fire. LA firefighters and police responded to the church on Chicago and 4th Street shortly before 8:30 p.m. The flames at the top of the bell tower burned without spreading to the rest of the church. Wearing only boxer shorts and a single sock, police say the man allegedly set the church's bell tower on fire and appeared to kick a second statue in an attempt to knock it over. The suspect attempted to evade police by jumping from rooftop to rooftop, and he was seen by news helicopters swinging on power lines before entering an apartment unit occupied by a family. The man was taken into custody around 10 p.m. and was transported to a hospital to be treated for his injuries. LA Metro officials announced Wednesday they will stop relying on law enforcement as a primary way of responding to unhoused people on the transportation system. LA Metro CEO Stephanie Wiggins said she feels law enforcement should not be the first point of contact with homeless individuals on the Metro system, but should serve to provide support for Metro's PATH homeless outreach team. After LAPD botched a detonation of illegal fireworks last Wednesday, the South Central Neighborhood Council unanimously passed a resolution on Monday calling on the city to compensate residents for injuries, property damage, and emotional distress. The blast occurred on East 27th Street and injured 17 residents and law enforcement officers, damaged cars and houses, and displaced dozens after local utilities had to shut off power and gas as a precaution. The council is also demanding the firing of whomever ordered the detonation and for their criminal prosecution, and called on the city council to change city policy so explosives are never intentionally detonated in residential communities. The resolution slammed the LAPD for its, quote, reckless and potentially life-threatening decision to detonate some of the fireworks in the middle of a densely populated neighborhood in one of California's poorest communities. Neighborhood Council Vice President Ron Gonchez said, "We hold firm to the belief that that would not have happened if we lived in an affluent community." Gocha said the South Central Neighborhood Council plans to offer assistance to residents who don't feel safe going into the resource center set up by the city's emergency management department at nearby Trinity Park, adding that the police presence dissuades people who are in the country illegally from seeking aid. The empty houses owned by Caltrans in the city of El Sereno are reported by Fox 11 News that $13 million of taxpayer money were paid to law enforcement to guard these empty houses over a period of 6 months. After extensive requests by Fox 11 to receive the costs spent to hire California Highway Patrol, Fox 11 was only able to get the data released once they were pressured by Fox 11's lawyers. The data showed that more than $4 million were paid to a private security company called Intercon for a period of 5 months, and more than $8 million were paid to the CHP for 6 months. The sum total came out to more than $13 million to guard 120 vacant homes along the 710 freeway corridor. Los Angeles City Councilman Kevin De Leon stated that he understood the need for security due to them attracting illegal activity, but said that the cost of securing them was quite exorbitant and could have been better spent. The California Department of Justice, Attorney General Rob Bonta, has told law enforcement agencies throughout the state that they must notify the state whenever a field office opens an investigation on police shootings that kill unarmed civilians. This guideline comes in response to a new law that took effect on July 1st, which requires Attorney General Bonta's office to independently probe all fatal police shootings of unarmed civilians to determine whether criminal charges should be filed against officers. Previous to the law, the Department of Justice was deferred to county prosecutors after they were investigated by the law enforcement agencies. Under the new law, Assembly Bill 1506, the DOJ must investigate the fatal police shootings and submit a written report that states the facts of the case, its analysis, provide a conclusion on each issue raised by the shooting, and recommend whether policies of the law enforcement agency should be changed. If the DOJ determines that criminal charges were unwarranted, it would then prosecute the officers. The state budget has approved $13 million to the staff investigation team. However, prior to Attorney General Rob Bonta's appointment, the Department of Justice determined that it would need $26 million to properly investigate the 40 deadly police shootings that the state is averaging each year. I'm Patrick Serrano for KQBH News, 101.5 FM, KQBH LP Los Angeles, California, a community service of the Boyle Heights Arts Conservatory, available to stream on the LPFM LA app and ednixon.com.